In this video, we'll see how to create a student performance meter. So where a student has marks less than 30, we'll call it as fail, 55% average, 70% good, 85% very good, and above 80% we'll call them as brilliant, and we'll represent that in the form of a meter. So let's say the student marks were 20%, so you will see the needle over there, 40% it is pointing to average, 60% it will point to good. And if we point to, let's say, 80%, it should go to very good bucket, and then more than 80%, it will fall in the brilliant bucket. So let us create all this from beginning. So I copy this title and we'll move on to a new worksheet. We'll replicate entire thing as it is in the new sheet. So I'm copying the reference table over there. Let us adjust the width. Now we need to insert a chart because we are developing everything in this, the entire meter, using different charts. So I have inserted a blank doughnut chart, and here in the series I am putting the values 2, 2, 1, 1, 1, 7. These numbers represent the area covered by different buckets. So initial two buckets, I have given more area, that's why 2 for these two. Then three buckets are of 1, and then last one is covering entire 50%. After that, once you click on OK, go to Format Data Series and change the rotation by 270. So if you close this, you will see that it is on the right position now. So now I go to below 1, I double click on it, and I change the background color of by fill to no fill. For the first one, I double click on it and I change the color to red. For the second one, I double click on it, specifically that one, not like this. You should make sure that it is selecting only that particular bucket. So if I change the color to orange, for this third one, I change the fill color to light green. Maybe this one or something else. We can choose 3 out of these. So we can pick this one for good, and for very good we can pick up a bit darker one, and then for the brilliant we can pick the darkest one. So we have a scale here. Now I can right click and I go to the properties of the charts and remove the borders of the chart. So now we have this chart. We can also remove these labels which we see on the right. Right, so now we have only the chart visible. Now the next part is, if I go here to the previous sheet, I copy the student marks section as it is. Here the student would be entering the marks. Okay, so here somewhere down below you need to use three different cells. In the one, you will be putting the actual marks of the student. In the second one, you will be putting the area covered by the needle. And in the third one, you will be covering the rest of the area. So I give 50%, let's say, to the first one, 2 or 3 or 5% for the needle one, and 145%, which is actually 200% minus sum of above 2, to the third one. So after that, again you need to right click on the chart, select data and add series. With series value, you select all these three cells. Then click on OK. Again you can click on OK. So you will see another Doughnut chart on top of it. But we need to change the chart type by right clicking and then change it to pie chart. Now you see two charts overlapping, the above one which we created earlier and this one. So now if you select this, you change the rotation to 270 degree, the chart that we just created, not the previous one. Now select on the other regions, change the fill color to white, or you can say transparent or no fill. So you will see only the area which is 5%, which would be of the area of the needle. Now change the plot axis to secondary. So you will see that needle on the top. Now you can specifically select that needle and change the fill color to not entire chart, but you need to specifically double click on that area and then right click and then fill, solid fill, black. Okay, so you will see a black needle on the top. Now you can also reduce the weight, or you can say width of the needle. Let's say you make it 2% now. So we kept it 5% earlier so that you can easily double click on it. Otherwise it is very thin and you won't be able to double click on that region. After that, insert a shape like this and try to fit it on the top of it. And then I change the background color to black, and then I am inserting the labels, which is according to the table that I have shown you earlier. So for red area, I am putting it as fail, increasing the font size, putting it here by making the background color transparent. Then I do it similarly for average, copy, paste. I do for good, copy, paste, and then I change the text color, text value or text to very good, and then I again copy and then paste for brilliant. So I have created this now. Now what I need to do, I can also insert another shape, which is a sphere shape, and I change the background to black. Now my performance meter is ready after just minor adjustments. Now if I change the percentage, let's say 20%, it will point to correct values. So friends, that's all. If you like our video, please subscribe, and you can share the video with your friends.